Mental models, how to train your brain to think in new ways. You can prepare your cerebrum to think better. Probably the most ideal approaches to do this is to grow the arrangement of mental models you use to think. Let me clarify what I mean by sharing a tale about a world-class scholar. I initially found what a psychological model was and how helpful the correct one could be while I was perusing a tale about Richard Feynman, the popular physicist. Feynman got his college degree from MIT and his PhD from Princeton. During that time, he built up a notoriety for dancing into the math division and taking care of issues that the splendid PhD understudies couldn't comprehend. At the point when individuals asked how he did it, Feynman guaranteed that his unmistakable advantage was not his knowledge, yet rather a methodology he learned in secondary school. As indicated by Feynman, his secondary school material science educator requested that he remain after class one day and gave him a test. Feynman, the educator stated, "You go on and you make an excessive commotion. I know why. You're exhausted. So I'm going to give you a book. You go up there in the back, in the corner, and study this book, and when you know it all that is right now, can talk once more." So every day, Feynman would stow away in the rear of the homeroom and study the book, Advanced Calculus by Woods, while the remainder of the class proceeded with their customary exercises. What's more, it was while considering this old analytics reading material that Feynman started to build up his own arrangement of mental models. That book told the best way to separate parameters under the vital sign, Feynman composed. Things being what they are, not shown particularly in the colleges, they don't accentuate it. In any case, I got on the most proficient method to utilize that strategy, and I utilized that one damn instrument over and over. So on the grounds that I was self-educated utilizing that book, I had curious strategies for doing integrals. The outcome was, the point at which the folks at MIT or Princeton experienced difficulty doing a specific vital, it was on the grounds that they couldn't do it with the standard strategies they had learned in school. In the event that it was a form mix, they would have discovered it. In the event that it was a straightforward arrangement development, they would have discovered it. At that point I go along and have a go at separating under the indispensable sign, and frequently it worked. So I got an extraordinary notoriety for doing integrals, simply because my case of apparatuses was not quite the same as everyone else's, and they had given every one of their instruments a shot at before giving the issue to me. Each PhD understudy at Princeton and MIT is splendid. What isolated Feynman from his companions wasn't really crude knowledge. It was the manner in which he saw the issue. He had a more extensive arrangement of mental models. What is a mental model? A psychological model is a clarification of how something functions. It is an idea, structure, or perspective that you heft around in your brain to assist you with interpreting the world and comprehend the connection between things. Mental models are profoundly held convictions about how the world functions. For instance, market interest is a psychological model that causes you to see how the economy functions. Game hypothesis is a psychological model that causes you see how connections and trust work. Entropy is a psychological model that encourages you see how issue and rot work. Mental models control your observation and conduct. They are the reasoning apparatuses that you use to get life, decide, and take care of issues. Learning another psychological model gives you another approach to see the world, like Richard Feynman learning another math system. Mental models are blemished, however valuable. There is no single mental model from material science or designing, for instance, that gives an immaculate clarification of the whole universe, yet the best mental models from those controls have permitted us to assemble scaffolds and streets, grow new advances, and even travel to space. As student of history Yuval Noah Harari puts it, researchers for the most part concur that no hypothesis is 100% right. In this manner, the genuine trial of information isn't truth, yet utility. The best mental models are the thoughts with the most utility. They are comprehensively helpful in day-by-day life. Understanding these ideas will assist you with settling on more astute decisions and take better activities. This is the reason building up a wide base of mental models is basic for anybody keen on intuition plainly, normally, and viably. The secret to great thinking and decision making. Extending your arrangement of mental models is something specialists need to take a shot at the same amount of as fledglings. We as a whole have our preferred mental models, the ones we normally default to as a clarification for how or why something occurred. As you become more seasoned and create aptitude in a specific zone, you will in general kindness the psychological models that are generally natural to you. Here's the issue: when a certain perspective commands your reasoning, you'll attempt to clarify each issue you face through that perspective. This trap is especially simple to slip into when you're shrewd or skilled in a given zone. The more you ace a solitary mental model, the almost certain it turns into that this psychological model will be your destruction, since you'll begin applying it unpredictably to each issue. What resembles aptitude is regularly a confinement. As the regular maxim says, if the sum total of what you have is a sledge, everything resembles a nail. Consider this model from scientist Robert Sapolsky. He asks, for what reason did the chicken go across the street? Then, he gives answers from various specialists. On the off chance that you ask a developmental scholar, they may state, the chicken went across the street since they saw a potential mate on the opposite side. On the off chance that you ask a kinesiologist, they may state, the chicken went across the street on the grounds that the muscles in the leg contracted and pulled the leg bone forward during each progression. On the off chance that you ask a neuroscientist, they may state, the chicken went across the street on the grounds that the neurons in the chicken's cerebrum terminated and set off the development. In fact, talking, none of these specialists aren't right. Be that as it may, no one is seeing the whole picture either. Every individual mental model is only one perspective on the real world. The difficulties and circumstances we face in life can't be altogether clarified by one field or industry. All points of view hold some fact. None of them contain the total truth. Depending on a limited arrangement of reasoning devices resembles wearing a psychological straitjacket. Your subjective scope of movement is constrained. At the point when your arrangement of mental models is restricted, so is your potential for finding an answer. So as to release your maximum capacity, you need to gather a scope of mental models. You need to work out your dynamic tool compartment. Along these lines, the key to incredible believing is to learn and utilize an assortment of mental models. Growing your set of mental models. The way toward amassing mental models is to some degree like improving your vision. Each eye can see something all alone. In any case, in the event that you spread one of them, you lose some portion of the scene. It's difficult to see the full picture when you're just glancing through one eye. So also, mental models give an inside image of how the world functions. We ought to persistently overhaul and improve the nature of this image. This implies perusing broadly from the best books, contemplating the essentials of apparently inconsequential fields, and gaining from individuals with uncontrollably extraordinary educational encounters. The inner consciousness needs an assortment of mental models to sort out a total image of how the world functions. The more sources you need to draw upon, the more clear your reasoning becomes. As the scholar Alan de Botton takes note of, the central foe of good choices is an absence of adequate viewpoints on an issue. The pursuit of liquid knowledge. In school, we will in general separate information into various storehouses: science, financial aspects, history, material science, theory. In reality, data is infrequently isolated into flawlessly characterized classifications. In the expressions of Charlie Munger, all the intelligence of the world isn't to be found in one minimal scholastic division. World-class masterminds are frequently storehouse-free scholars. They abstain from taking a gander at life through the viewpoint of one subject. Rather, they create fluid information that streams effectively starting with one point then onto the next. This is the reason it is critical to learn new mental models, yet to consider how they interface with each other. Inventiveness and advancement regularly emerge at the crossing point of thoughts. By detecting the connections between different mental models, you can distinguish arrangements that a great many people neglect. Instruments for thinking better. Here's the uplifting news. You don't have to ace everything about each subject to turn into a world-class mastermind. Of all the psychological models mankind has created since the beginning, there are only two or three dozen that you have to figure out how to have a firm handle of how the world functions. Huge numbers of the most significant mental models are the large thoughts from disciplines like science, material science, financial aspects, arithmetic, brain research, reasoning. Each field has a couple of mental models that structure the foundation of the subject. For instance, a portion of the column mental models from financial matters incorporate thoughts like incentives, scarcity, and economies of scale. In the event that you can ace the essentials of each control, at that point you can build up a strikingly precise and helpful image of life. To cite Charlie Munger once more, 80 or 90 significant models will convey around 90% of the cargo in making you an experienced individual. What's more, of those, solitary or unimportant bunch truly convey overwhelming cargo. I've made it an individual strategic reveal the enormous models that convey the substantial cargo throughout everyday life. In the wake of inquiring about in excess of 1,000 distinctive mental models, I steadily limited it down to a couple dozen that issue most. I've expounded on some of them beforehand, similar to entropy and reversal, and I'll be covering a greater amount of them later on. In case you're intrigued, you can peruse my gradually extending rundown of mental models.